In this video, you're going to learn 6 quick tips to build better apps using Bolt AI. So tip number 1. So here we are in Bolt, and I'm going to show you an app that I built previously, which is a plant identification app. And you can see the design here is pretty nice, and I did this with one simple prompt. So all you have to do is after Bolt builds your initial prototype, you want to say something like, now please update the design and keep all the functionality. I want you to design it similar to blank. And blank is going to be an app that you think has nice design. So in my case, I said similar to Spotify's design. So as a result, this app has similar colors and fonts to Spotify, and it's just a really nice way to quickly add nice design to your app. You can always change it up later, but it's something I really recommend, and it's a really easy tip that you can use. Okay, so tip number 2. This is when you are working with OpenAI or an API endpoint. Sometimes, so for example, in this plant identifier app, when I was building it, it was trying to use an API model that is no longer supported because Bolt was trained on an older model. So what I did was I went to the OpenAI documentation, I went to Vision, and then I went and I reviewed it, and I literally copy and pasted the documentation from OpenAI. You can either go to the documentation or the API reference and go down to Vision model. And this is where sometimes you just have to give the information to Bolt. So it thought that the model was like GPT-Vision, when in reality, the way that OpenAI needs it in its most updated documentation is GPT-4.0, and then that's the model, and then you pass through the image for the plant identification app. So this is something that you need to be aware of. Sometimes if it's not working, you do need to go yourself, look at the documentation, and then give it the information. So tip number 3 is what to do when Bolt doesn't want to listen to what you have to say. So in this specific example, when I gave it that documentation, Bolt actually responded and said, you are wrong, I'm going to continue doing it the way that I had with the older model. And what you have to do is respond as if you were speaking to a human and say, I've done the research, please try it out, even if it's just experimental, and let's see what happens. So you sometimes have to kind of convince the AI to do it your way. And I did that, and I was pretty sure I was going to be correct, and it turned out I was. Just the general tip is you can't rely fully on Bolt to know everything right out of the box. You have to think of it more like you're a partner and you're working together. The next tip for Bolt is sometimes you're going to have to go into the code and update information, and you can ask the Bolt chatbot how to do this. So just as an example, let's say I'm in the preview. I am identifying a plant. Let me add one real quick. So let's say I'm identifying, I click identify plant, and it says there's an error. So what I can say is, where do I put the correct API key? So if I ask Bolt that question, it's going to tell me, it's actually going to go to the part of the code where I need to enter the key, and it's going to let me know. So it's creating an environment file. You just have to give it a second here. So here it's telling me exactly what to do. So go over to our code, go to the .env file, and then it wants me to copy it, replace the API key with my actual one, and then it will ignore it for security. So for example, basically the high level tip here is you need to just ask how to go into the code. And if you're still confused, you could say, I'm not sure where to go, etc. And you can kind of just go back and forth. So even if you don't fully understand what all of these code pages mean or if it feels a little overwhelming, the tip is to just ask the chatbot and it'll help you solve it. The next tip is to utilize bolts, buttons here that can help try to solve a problem automatically. So when there is an issue, it's gonna identify what that issue is, and then you can just press a button, for example, try to fix problem, and if you click that button, Bolt will automatically try to resolve the problem. This is a good way to take a first stab at trying to solve a problem. It won't always work. For example, like I was saying before, when Bolt was trying to use the API model from ChatGPT that was no longer valid, it was trying to continue using it because it just didn't know. So that's where you have to step in. But that is a really helpful tip to know that Bolt has that functionality to try to resolve things itself. So here we can see we tried to resolve it and there is still an issue. So you could keep clicking it, you could try it again, or you might want to start investigating, asking it questions, and going from there. The next tip is around prompt construction. So it's helpful to give examples as much as you can. So right here, if I wanted to build an upvote site, I could just say build an upvote site, but it's helpful to say like Product Hunt. Giving it that example is going to help you get a better result. So I'm clicking that, it's going to load, and then it kind of knows what to do right off the bat by giving it that example. So that's a really helpful tip in your prompt construction. Thanks for watching. I hope you found this helpful. Be sure to check out our other Bolt AI and no-code videos right here on the channel. Subscribe to get access to all of that content here for free. Check the link in the description to subscribe to our AI and no-code newsletter. The space moves really quickly and you want to make sure you're getting all the information as soon as it's released. Thanks again for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.